Next up, we're diving right into amateur Muay Thai. It will be 3 2-minute rounds. Welcome to the NFC cage out of the blue corner, X-Zavier! Jones!
X-Zavier Jones, one of many fighters making their debut here tonight at NFC 158. Xavier fighting out of GTA Gwinnett Training Academy under Amir Dodovic. Xavier hailing from Stone Mountain, Georgia. And Lawson, we say it every show, you have no idea what to expect from these young men and women during their first bout. Some of these guys, they get in there, they're maybe a little timid, a little nervous. Some of them look like they've been doing this their whole life.
I agree. You never know, Jim. As we've seen before, you can get guys in there at 0-0, and all of a sudden they look like polished pros. Some of these up-and-comers, they are already just put so much time and effort in that they come out here just hot rodding, ready to go, really. Throwing fancy techniques. We see spinning heel kicks, jumping knees all the time. Knockouts not uncommon in these debut fights.
And his opponent heading to the cage, competing out of the red corner, Steve Cano.
Oh, I see Steve Cano has brought a cheering section this evening. Not Steve's debut. This is actually Steve's third Muay Thai battle. We've seen him twice in the NFC, most recently at NFC 55 back in June, where he went to a majority draw with Sam Davis. That right there, Lawson, gives him a little bit of the edge. Two fights may not seem like a lot, but that's two more times that his opponent will have, and that's a chance to get used to the way it feels, to work out some of the jitters. I know I felt very different in my third bout versus my first.
I would definitely agree. That first one is very much, you know, there's no time like the first time, Jim. Let's be real. Man, trying not
competing out of the blue corner. This 21-year-old is making his NFC debut this evening. Standing 6'3" tall, fighting out of Gwinnett Training Academy. Hailing locally from Stone Mountain, Georgia, put your hands together for X-Zavier Jones. Across the cage, out of the red corner, this undefeated 22-year-old stands 5'8" tall with a record of 1 victory, 0 defeats, fighting out of ATT Team Lima. Hailing from Lawrenceville, Georgia, Steve Cano.
Distinct height advantage in this fight going to X-Zavier Jones.
That is the first thing. It's very obvious. You've got a 7-inch height advantage, and that translates right over to the reach. You see the crazy length of those arms and legs of X-Zavier Jones. We'll see how that comes into play.
Immediately, X-Zavier with the body kick. Ooh, drops him with the first right hand thrown. My word.
We've got an 8 count in 3 seconds. I'd say a good start for X-Zavier Jones' Muay Thai career.
Man, he is unloading already on Steve Cano. Ooh.
Referee in charge, one of the veterans, not just of the Southeast, but the world, Blake Grice.
That's got to be something to maybe making your amateur Muay Thai debut, and you have a veteran UFC ref in there with you.
Yeah, they may not even know who he is, but if they did, they'd be impressed.
Right? Very rarely do they notice the third man in the ring, but Blake is one of the best.
Now, this is going to be the challenge for Steve Cano, is getting inside of that reach. You see Xavier very light on his feet, moving in and out.
Very light on his feet. He's landing that southpaw jab at will almost.
Yeah, and you see Steve lunging into those shots. Very easy to do when you're making up that kind of height disparity. Xavier just using those kicks, which is smart when you're the taller fighter. You've got a lot of reach on those legs. It's easier to keep an opponent away.
He is just sniping away at Steve from his striking distance right here. Ooh, nice question mark kick there. Narrowly misses.
Very likely Xavier has a background in karate or taekwondo.
I was thinking the same thing, Jim, just judging by his movement.
The bladed stance, the manipulation of the knees with those question mark kicks, it's very karate. Steve Cano is going to want to take advantage of those roundhouse kicks. Those create a great opportunity to get inside.
Boom. Landing that 1-2. Another body kick. Xavier Jones definitely took that round.
What a first round for Xavier Jones. We just said it. That guy looked incredibly smooth. He came in, he brought the heat, but unlike a lot of debut fighters, he was controlled. I mean, he paced himself. He kept that heat coming for two straight minutes. There you see two of the best corners in the biz, Diego Lima, Brantley Fur of American Top Team in Duluth. Hands down the most active fight team here in the Atlanta area. This is the first of many American Top Team competitors we'll see here this evening.
As always, there should be a ATT Lima stool in one corner, just designated.
Here we go, round number two. Reminder, Muay Thai amateur is 2 minutes, so a little bit shorter round as we ease these guys into the sport. To the spectators on the outside, that 2 minutes goes by really quickly. Sometimes when you're in there, it feels like you're in there for 20 minutes.
Oh, absolutely. That time dilation is real.
We'll see what kind of adjustments Steve Cano makes for round two. Already more aggressive. Very impressive, the clinch work and firing off the break by Xavier Jones.
I was about to say, Xavier just matching that aggressiveness as soon as he meets Steve Cano. Looks like Cano is now bleeding from the nose just a little bit.
Yeah, he got busted open in round number one. Steve doing a good job when he comes inside. He is gluing that left hand to his face, playing nice and tight, which you got to do with a big, rangy opponent.
Absolutely. If you're not controlling that inside, oh, catches Steve as he's on 1 foot with a solid, solid jab.
We have a slippery canvas here tonight. That's the third or fourth time Steve's fallen down on a kick. A little tumble.
As a fighter, I always like to get in the cage and just feel it around with my feet, see how it feels.
Oh, absolutely. Because every canvas feels a little different.
That's right.
And especially if you get a new one with new logos on it, it's going to be a little slippery.
It can be slick. You got to test to see if those logos are extra slick sometimes. Break and back to the center.
Clinch is allowed in these Muay Thai bouts, but referee Blake Grice, a veteran, as soon as he senses that clinch is not active, he's going to split the guys up, which I really appreciate. Some good defense, good parries there from Steve Cano.
Ooh, heavy kick from Xavier Jones. Jumping knee. Just misses.
Steve was able to block that with the arm, but you still feel those kicks.
Oh, absolutely.
Steve being a lot more aggressive here in the second round, but having trouble putting hands on Xavier.
Xavier just extremely elusive, managing his distance extraordinarily well. As we said, Jim, some amateurs are just so polished when they get in there.
End of the round there, we saw Steve land a leg kick. And that typically, when you're going against a tall, lengthy fighter, you like to chop at those legs. It's an easier target to hit. Sometimes trying to get to the head on a guy who's 7 inches taller than you is a, no pun intended, a very tall task.
Absolutely. And as we already saw, he tried to throw a high kick and caught a solid straight and landed on his butt.
Fans, we have 15 bouts coming at you this evening. We are only getting started. Mixture of MMA, Muay Thai, wrestling, and jiu-jitsu. So stay tuned. We've got amateur fights and pro coming at the end of the evening.
Just a quick reminder, we have bar food in the back. Bathrooms both sides over by the entryway and this backside over here as well. And an additional bar in the front entrance as well.
We head into round number three, where it's safe to assume that Xavier Jones is going to be up not only two rounds, but that first round he got a knockdown, so that's a 10-8 round. In other words, Steve Cano is going to need a finish in this third round.
Absolutely. I would wholeheartedly agree. Steve has taken some terrific punishment already this fight. He needs to do something terrific here in order to turn this third round around.
He did better in round number two. That first round, I think he got caught, you know, early, and that kind of shook him. And right away, Xavier using that teep again, trying to keep the distance.
Steve almost going for a single leg there. I think he got a little confused. Boom, another jumping knee. Boom, two more quick knees, three, four, bam. Xavier just firing off at will here.
Almost caught a knee to the face. Now, again, no knees to the face, but if it's incidental, if you throw a kick and your opponent ducks into it, that is legal.
That definitely happens.
Steve Cano definitely stunned here. His nose is opened up. He has not been able to find a solution for this length of Xavier Jones.
You can tell that he's starting to really feel the sting of those straight punches as his nose is leaking. And I can say from experience, getting hit in a broken nose hurts. It hurts a great deal.
Yeah, and it's annoying. You can't breathe.
No, not even a little bit.
You got to breathe out of your mouth. And, ooh, great counter by Xavier Jones as Steve was spinning out of that.
Very, very impressed with Xavier Jones' timing and poise here.
Steve will make some good moves to get inside, but when you're the shorter fighter and you get inside, you have to stay there. He gets inside and throws a shot, and then he shoulder rolls and backs out, which is exactly what Xavier Jones wants.
Yes. As the taller fighter, he wants him backing out.
Big shots down the middle.
Steve Cano looking like he's hurting right here.
Yeah, both fighters slowing down, but only one of them looks tired and a little hurt.
Absolutely. Xavier Jones has definitely put in some work on the body this fight.
See Xavier eyeing that clock. It's all about energy management. You find that out your first time out there.
Absolutely.
Our first Muay Thai bout of the evening did not disappoint. This one goes to the judges. Steve Cano and Xavier Jones. Friday, 6 days from now, NFC 159, the biggest show of the year. This card is absolutely stacked. Friday, October 20th, 16 fights, including four title fights. Earlier you heard about NFC's first ever father-son outing, as both Devon and his dad, OC, will competing in Muay Thai action. OC might be doing MMA on that card next Friday night. You've also got the undefeated Alex Gordy taking on Idol Gladney. It's 5-0 versus 4-1 as these guys fight for the NFC Bantamweight Championship. Standing room is
After
all that we have left.
Hard-fought rounds, the decision heads to the judges. With a unanimous decision, out of the blue corner, Xavier